Hello, I am Dr. Prashant Kumar. Today I am going to briefly review about PMD. What is PMD? What is the pathophysiology behind PMD? What is the similarities of PMD with severe sepsis and septic shock? It can cause a great lot of confusion with severe sepsis and septic shock. And what is the best clinical practice behind PMD? Let us see.
Post cardiac arrest myocardial dysfunction. Let us begin with a case. A 29-year-old female, ASA1, presented for tubal reanastomosis surgery. Preoperative echocardiography was absolutely normal. She suffered intraoperative cardiac arrest due to hemorrhage. CPR was conducted and Roche was achieved. She required increasing doses of inotropes in the post-resuscitation phase. About 2 hours later, 2D echocardiography was done in view of persistent hypotension and unresponsive pulmonary edema. She showed ejection fraction of 35% with global hypokinesia. Diagnosis of post-cardiac arrest myocardial dysfunction was made. Post-cardiac arrest syndrome. Post-cardiac arrest brain injury, post-cardiac arrest myocardial dysfunction, systemic ischemia reperfusion injury, persistent precipitating pathology. So, after a patient suffers cardiac arrest, we have broadly these four kind of manifestation. What is PMD? Myocardial dysfunction seen in survivors of cardiac arrest with no previous cardiac pathology. Manifestations of PMD. Echocardiography is the first line diagnostic test for PMD, showing reduced ejection fraction in previously normal cardiac function, systolic dysfunction and diastolic dysfunction. So PMD can present as cardiac dysfunction, both systolic and diastolic, but diastolic dysfunction is less common. Shock and vasopressor dependence alone without echocardiography findings are not diagnostic of PMD. Shock may result from vascular dysfunction and other causes without PMD. Onset. PMD can be seen to start within few minutes to up to 4 to 7 hours after cardiac arrest. Immediately after resuscitation, heart rate and blood pressure may be extremely high due to various factors including epinephrine used during CPR. So-called honeymoon period. I have included this study which was recently published, which has questioned the use of epinephrine routinely in cases of CPR. During CPR, epinephrine is used, and this study showed that epinephrine may lead to early Roche, but overall hospital discharge and recovery is poor in cases where epinephrine is used. So that is another story. Course. Initial hyperkinesia immediately after resuscitation is followed by hypokinesia. In surviving patients, complete recovery is seen in most of the patients after 48 to 72 hours. Low cardiac output peaks at 24 hours and mostly recovers in survivors in up to 72 hours. Requirements of increasing doses of inotropes indicates early death. Left ventricular systolic dysfunction. Apical segments display more severe wall motion abnormalities with a sparing of basal segments, a finding also seen in stress cardiomyopathy. Pre-existing left ventricular systolic dysfunction cannot be distinguished from reversible PMD as the cause of reduced left ventricular ejection fraction after Roche in cardiac arrest survivors without MI and may be prognostically more important. So this is clear that patients having poor ejection fraction beforehand and suffers cardiac arrest cannot be differentiated whether this cardiac dysfunction on echocardiography is PMD or it is pre-existing. If it is PMD and the patient is a survivor of CPR, it may likely recover within 48 to 72 hours. That is the clinical significance here. Cardiac arrest is severest form of shock. When there occurs a cardiac arrest, the whole of the body of the patient goes into a state of ischemia. Afterwards, when the patient has re-establishment of circulation, at that time there is reperfusion. So this entire condition leads to ischemia reperfusion injury syndrome that leads to excessive amount of cytokine release in the whole of the body. The situation is similar to sepsis, where there is excessive amount of cytokines. Ischemia reperfusion injury. Cellular energy depletion leads to failure of the membrane sodium potassium ATPase pump with intracellular sodium overload and cell edema. With restoration of blood flow after transient ischemia, overproduction of toxic reactive oxygen species leads to second wave of cellular injury. Inflammatory cardiovascular dysfunction. IRI after rash triggers a release of inflammatory cytokines leading to SIRS that mimics sepsis, even in absence of infection. This is very important. Various cytokines have direct depressant effect on cardiac myocyte contractility, contributing to both systolic and diastolic dysfunction as in septic cardiomyopathy. Catecholamine induced cardiac dysfunction. Catecholamine excess produces myocardial injury and cardiac dysfunction through multiple mechanisms including calcium overload, Roche overproduction, and beta receptor downregulation and desensitization. Relative vasopressin and cortisol deficiency. Studies have demonstrated endocrine dysfunction with relative deficiency of vasopressin and cortisol after Roche, similar to sepsis. Additional factor, DC shock. Increased number of DC shock is associated with PMD. Amiodarone, propofol and remifentanil used during CPR or before CPR has been shown to have direct effect on PMD. That means these agents may contribute to the development of PMD. Therapeutic hypothermia. Patients on therapeutic hypothermia have lower heart rate, lower cardiac index, higher SVR, but clinical studies show that hemodynamic changes resulting from therapeutic hypothermia are not harmful per se and the patients have improved outcome. Now we are going to see what is the best clinical practices about PMD. About oxygenation and ventilation. Only use sufficient FiO2 after Roche to avoid hypoxia. Bring down FiO2 as long as peripheral oxygen saturation is maintained above 94% or PO2 above 60 mm of mercury or both. Ventilate to achieve normocardia and monitor with arterial blood gas. Monitoring. Every patient suffering from cardiac arrest should receive invasive monitoring. Hemodynamic optimization. A focused goal-directed approach can be modeled on parameters used in sepsis. So what are the vasopressors? What are the agents which are good for blood pressure response in these patients? So evidence shows that first line vasopressor should be norepinephrine and the second line should be epinephrine. The traditional dopamine should not be used in patients who are having PMD because it has shown to increase risk of arrhythmias. Vasopressin and low dose steroids should be used similar to sepsis. So here we see that as the relative vasopressin deficiency in sepsis and steroid uses in sepsis, we can use steroid and vasopressin in PMD also. What is the target map after PMD? Most of the cases who are having cardiac arrest and return of spontaneous circulation, they are hemodynamically very labile. Some patients have blood pressure in shooting to very high level and some patients may have blood pressure in the lower range. Of course, if the patient has lower blood pressure, we should use a vasoactive medication like norepinephrine and epinephrine to increase mean arterial pressure. But what should be the mean arterial pressure? The studies showed that mean arterial pressure minimum 65 up to 85 is good. If mean arterial pressure without any vasopressor is up to 100, that is also acceptable. But if mean arterial pressure is above 100 millimeter of mercury, after adequate sedation, patient is on mechanical ventilation, then a vasodilator and beta blocker should be used to reduce blood pressure. This point is very important and should be taken care of and should be considered while taking care of a patient who is on PAMD. Inotropic agents. Dobutamine should be used in the following conditions. If there is lactic acidosis or low SVO2, then dobutamine is warranted. If dobutamine leads to hypotension, epinephrine may be a good inotrope. Mildrenone is a good choice if dobutamine is ineffective. Beta receptor downregulation. So in the pathophysiology, we have seen that when we use excessive amount of epinephrine during CPR, that exposure to epinephrine leads to downregulation of beta receptors in the heart. Particularly, the area of the cardiac apex is very high dense beta receptor. So in those conditions, afterwards the patient may be unresponsive to epinephrine and inotrope of sympathomimetic agent. In those conditions, mildrenone is a second choice and may be used. Circulatory support. What is the status of IABP, Impella and ECMO? We have one study, SHOCK 2 trial, which showed to show any failed to show any benefit of IABP. But there is no large recommendation or large studies or good recommendation about Impella or ECMO devices. So that can be considered on case-to-case basis according to the opinion of the caring physicians, but is not strongly recommended or denied. Management of ACS. This is very important and day-to-day clinical situation. Recognition and treatment of ACS are critical in post-cardiac arrest patient. In suspected ACS as cause of cardiac arrest, PCI is always recommended. If facilities for PCI is enabled, thrombolysis is appropriate alternative. So if there is a suspicion of ACS as cause of cardiac arrest and the patient has returned return of spontaneous circulation, those cases must be considered for early angiography and proper management, whatever is deemed fit. Therapeutic hypothermia. Hyperthermia should be avoided at all cost in patient with post cardiac arrest syndrome. A simple means of inducing hypothermia in emergency department is by administration of 30 ml per kg of ice cold saline. Cooling blankets may be used and the patient can go for coronary intervention while having therapeutic hypothermia. What is the place of antibiotic? Only a word of caution here. Many patients who have cardiac arrest before requires increasing doses of inotropes, vasopressors, and they are confused to have acquired sepsis kind of thing. So if we are aware about the condition PAMD, shock state, and we know that the patient has not acquired sepsis and there is another condition of SIRS which is very similar to sepsis, then we may avoid unnecessary excessive use of antibiotics here. But if the caring physician think that the patient is clinically infected, sepsis is there, then should not refrain from using appropriate antibiotic at right time. So in conditions of PAMD shock state, increasing doses of inotropes should not be presumed to have sepsis unless there is good clinical reasons to believe so. Case specific therapies. So treatment of persistent condition that cause the cardiac arrest must be disease specific and coordinated with other aspects of care.